I should also that this kind of category, where you put this condition of having inclusion of the outgoing boundary being zero connected, was I think it's occurred several places in mathematics, but it was introduced for this purpose of studying kind of infinite genus surfaces in Ulrike Tillmann's paper in 95. If I have time, I'll say a little bit more about that later. So, so we have this functor that sends M0 to colimit of C20 M0 S1, and then colimit over gluing a cylinder, connect some RP2. If I do it on the space level, it's better to say homotopy colimit, so also known as mapping telescope. That goes into spaces, and it's contravariant. This sends all morphisms to homologized morphisms. That's what was stated here. Then there's a completely formal argument. That that this colimit homology of C20 M0 S1 so the kind of common value of all these functors is homology of the loop space or the classifying space of the category. via this map I've erased now that you have C20 M0 S1, I call it alpha, to the space of paths from M0 to S1 in the classifying space of the category. So if I take induced map on homology, then take direct limit, where in this case I'm just concatenating with a path, that's a homotopy equivalence. so on this side I don't need to take this colimit. And then I just have this thing here. Okay, so I still want to read this as it's the left-hand side I'm interested in. This is it's some homology of some morphism space, not on the nose, but in the direct limit over multiplying, composing with the same element infinitely many times. So it's a little bit like localizing a ring or something. yes. the oriented version of this is due to Hera much earlier, in like 85 or so. He proved homological stability for orientable surfaces. And there's a version of this argument as well there. right.
if I think about topological, you know, 2D topological in terms of homogeneous elements, the handle adding operator is some operator. Are you somehow projecting to the, you know, the largest eigenvalue or something? Because if you start composing that very comments,
I didn't understand that, but it did not sound relevant. it sounded complicated in a different way from what I was saying here. In some ways, a lot of things become kind of trivial when we take this direct limit. so that's one thing about this thing. Then there's another. Okay. So now suppose I understood this right-hand side, I would have calculated the homology of classifying space of diffeomorphism groups of non-orientable surfaces, at least after connect-summing with RP2 infinitely often. And that's in fact the case. So there's another theorem, which in dimension 2 is also in this paper with Madsen, Tillman, and Weiss. That the inclusion, I mean, it was a subcategory. I just imposed some condition. So there's an inclusion functor this is a weak equivalence. So even though it's kind of a somewhat drastic operation, throwing out a bunch of path components, you don't see that after taking classifying space of the category. So then we can combine that with what I said before. So using that here, I get instead the loop space of the full two-dimensional unoriented cobordism category, of which we at least have a name for the homotopy type. And here the here the rational cohomology is this polynomial ring. So this is the so a corollary of that. The cohomology here turns out to be a free commutative algebra, it's a polynomial ring on infinitely many generators, one in each degree divisible by 4. That's what the co-limit, or the limit, I suppose, if you take cohomology of B diff of G many copies of RP2, say with a disk removed, or connect some with D2. Take the rational cohomology in the limit where G goes to infinity. So if you take cohomology, it becomes a co-limit. has the same homology as a path component of this space, which is this thing here. So that's the kind of statement you can get out of this machinery. It's not particular surfaces, but it's typically in some sort of limit where you keep gluing something onto the surface.
What factor are you using about homology isomorphisms?
Right, this so this squiggly arrow here. So it's precisely this statement that if you have a I think I wrote something slightly more precise in the well I wrote something in the notes, you have a pro object, I guess you can call it. You have this, I'm using this fact that, first of all, I'm taking homology of morphism spaces, I'm taking hom into something fixed, and then I postcompose with some fixed morphism infinitely many times. Then I'm using that, after doing that, gluing something else on the other end induces a homology isomorphism. so you can axiomatize it if you have a topologically enriched category, there should be some filtered direct system of objects so that if you take hom into that, take homotopy co-limit, it should as a functor of the remaining variable, it should send everything to homologized morphisms. So I'm using something slightly weaker than what Natalie proved. Anyway. Yes. They're kind of unoriented versions of that. Oh, I mean, they come from integral homology. I just this was an isomorphism. That's what I meant to say. But these classes are integral if you define them the right way. Yeah. Okay. The only reason I said the non-oriented version is because I've been not emphasizing tangential structures so much. In this surface case, most things were done in the oriented case before the unoriented. So as I said, the analog of Wahl's theorem is due to Hera. The analog of this statement is due to Madsen and Weiss. Used to be the Mumford conjecture. The answer looks a little bit different if you have a class in each even degree, but otherwise it's sort of a similar flavor if you have connected surfaces. And before all that, or before the Madsen-Weiss theorem, Ulrike Tillmann had already proved that that Hochkolim B diff of a genus G surface take the direct limit where G goes to infinity has the same homology as an infinite loop space. And the method she proved this sort of was precisely using this condition on cobordisms that inclusion of outgoing boundaries should be zero connected. okay, there's of course a lot more to say, but that was sort of the main object, precisely this category. So all this also works in higher dimensions. At least if the higher dimension is even. So there, most of it is joint work with Oscar Randall Williams. So this subcategory, the inclusion is a weak equivalence provided K is, what is it? D over 2. That's what it is if D is even. Forgotten if it's this or. Just look up the statement. If I wrote it down. Somewhere. Okay. Okay, I think this is true. So as long as you only impose roughly up to half the dimension connected, you don't change the homotopy type of the classifying space of the category. I guess if you want to, you could think of that in terms of field theories as like functors out of this category into a groupoid in a homotopical sense, canonically extend to this bigger thing. Anyway, I'll just use this statement. If D is 2n, which so even, then the furthest this applies is n minus 1, 2n. So we prove that. But also, the analog of homological stability also applies as long as you use this category. So let me state it slightly imprecisely. There exists some direct system so that if I send if I take colimit of homology of the morphism space in this category from M0 into in the notes I call it x of j, but also there's some I think I put it in the wrong entry, so I'll have to update the notes. It should be in this entry. So there exists some direct system, so there's some indexing category that's filtered. So I suppose that's called an int object. It's filtered, but you can actually always use the natural numbers with the ordering. So maybe I should just have said that. You take hom into something, and and you keep composing with something that behaves a little bit like this RP2 in the non-oriented surfaces case. After doing that, you still have functoriality in the first entry. And this functor sends any morphism to an isomorphism. So this is again a homological stability theorem. If you like, you can put the colimit inside as a homotopy colimit. You have a functor into spaces that sends any morphism to a map of spaces that is a so-called homology isomorphism, induces isomorphism on integral homology. This is again a kind of homological stability. And this same formal argument tells you then that that this must be isomorphic to the homology of a homology of the loop space of this category, which by this theorem is the same as this one, and this is so homology of what's then called MTO 2N, the colimit over V of omega V T D comma V. and the rational, oops, D was 2N. The rational cohomology of each path component is known, and it's what I said before. It's a polynomial ring on monomials in Pontryagin classes. So we didn't quite calculate cohomology of Hom spaces in the category, but we did that after gluing on something kind of infinitely many times. It's not just existence statement, it's kind of something explicit, and that behaves. So for 8 manifolds, for example, you can use infinitely many copies of HP2. Let's see, is there more I wanted to say? Yes, one more thing. It's also known how this, two more things. There are versions of both with tangential structures, for example, orientations. Get formulas for homology of orientation preserving diffeomorphisms. And they're also on a slightly stronger assumptions, but not too strong. There are also some stronger homological stability theorems that that in fact, if you fix the homological degree and stick to one path component, then this direct system stabilizes. After a certain point, gluing on, for example, more copies of RP2 or the analog of that in higher dimensions does not change the homology. Okay, let me stop there. In the oriented surface case, you glue on that. depends a little on what structure you have. So in general, this system will depend on what the structure is. In the basic, I mean, yes, I guess you can always use let me answer that. Later. Let me think for a moment. other questions? Yes. The only thing, I mean, everything is kind of integral, actually, except for the calculation of what you get at the end. You get some infinite loop space. You have to work out what is the cohomology. And at that point, there's sort of a simple answer rationally. And with some other coefficients, you probably have to do a lot of work.
Do you get then the, like, basically the Manifold multi-tabular classes where you start with these switching classes, or are there more?
There's a lot more. Yeah, so the, if you have an infinite loop space, likely the, the mod P homology is quite complicated. So there's so-called dielessive operations that you can apply to stuff and, yeah, quite complicated. Yep.
So you said that you stabilize using something like SN cross SN. What happens if you pick some other manifold to stabilize?
like, for example, if you have a 6 manifold and you do S2 cross S2 cross S2,
sure.
I don't know the answer to that. I've gotten that question quite often, but yeah, there seems to be, I mean, there are many things we don't understand yet, but for example, we don't exactly know how the story goes in odd dimension. Certainly middle dimension plays a very special role, as it's often done in high dimensional manifold theory. And it's kind of seems important that what you're stabilizing with is sort of adding middle dimensional handles. Good question. I don't